Generally speaking, electrical conductors consist of a number of wires stranded together on machines such as these. The numbers run in the progression 7, 19, 37, 61, 91, up to the largest stranded conductor of 127. Vapor was first used as an insulator by Dr. Ferranti. The first vapor-insulated electric cable in Europe was made by the BI. Watch them being made today. After the insulation of the individual conductors, they are placed in a laying-up machine for the construction of cables containing three or more cores. The spaces between conductors are filled with jute, which gives a firm bed to the cores. Now another insulation of paper. As many as 70 papers, giving a thickness of 1/3 of an inch, can be put on in one operation. This machine is actually putting on 24 lappings. A slow motion picture shows you how perfectly the machine does the lapping. Now we come to the largest laying-up machine in this country, dealing with three cores, each insulated for 33,000 volts and covered with a lead sheath. The metal sheath on the individual conductors is to ensure even radial electrical stress on the insulation, a very important matter where high working pressures are involved. Spaces between the lead-covered conductors are filled in with jute. As the conductors and jute are laid together, you can see how perfectly they form, ready for the paper insulation. Thorough impregnation of the insulation is essential before the cable is covered with a sheath of lead. This hydraulic press forces lead round the cable, which, when formed, provides a sure barrier against moisture. We are now in the test house, where all cables are immersed in a water tank for a period of 24 hours. Any defects of the lead sheath cause ingress of water to the cable, which is immediately discovered when the cable comes to be tested. Cables are tested for insulation and subjected to a pressure test of several times the voltage at which they will be put to work. Between the tanks, they are measuring cables and cutting them to length to suit customers' requirements, which are governed by the distance between the joint boxes and other similar conditions. Lead, of course, is a protection against moisture, but lead in its turn must be protected against damage. So we have brought you to the armoring shop, where steel wires are laid onto a bed of jute string. Another method of protection is provided by steel tapes, which are put on in such a manner that one tape covers the gap of the spiral formed by the other tape.